So in this video, I want to talk about the Laplacian. We have talked about the gradient, the divergence, and the curl already. They all use this del operator, which is a differential operator. The Laplacian is written as del squared, which comes from this differential operator dotted with itself. These unit vectors are orthonormal, so this is just the derivatives d squared dx squared plus d squared dy squared plus d squared dz squared. So the sum of the second partial derivatives. This is called the Laplacian operator. It can act on both a scalar field or a vector field. So for a scalar field, we would have del squared f would be d squared f dx squared plus d squared f dy squared plus d squared f dz squared, okay? What about if del squared, the Laplacian acts on a vector field? So for a vector field, we could write del squared u. How you interpret this is that del squared acts on each component of u. So this would be del squared u1 times I plus del squared u2 times j plus del squared u3 times k. Okay? Why is the Laplacian so important? It's because it shows up in a lot of PDEs. So let me show you some PDEs. So the PDEs is, this is a partial differential equation. I talk about PDEs in my differential equations for engineers course. Let me give you some representative PDEs where you have the Laplacian. The first one is simply del squared scalar field equal to zero. That's just called the Laplace equation after the Laplacian and after the mathematician Laplace. The next one would be the wave equation. The wave equation is the second derivative of some scalar times dt squared, and that's equal to c squared times the Laplacian of the scalar. So that's the wave equation. Okay, it's called the wave equation because the solution is going to be waves. It can govern things like the music that's made from a guitar string, for instance. It also governs electromagnetic waves, and in fact, we'll derive this equation for the electric field and the magnetic field. The third equation, which I want to present, is the diffusion equation, which is a first derivative with respect to time, d phi dt, equals a diffusion constant times del squared phi. So this is the diffusion equation. Okay, so that governs the diffusion of a dye, say, in some fluid, such as water. This is an equation which I actually solve in my course, Differential Equation for Engineers. Okay, so let me give you an example then of the Laplacian acting on a scalar field, a rather simple example. What would be the Laplacian of the scalar field given by x squared plus y squared plus z squared? Okay, very simple. This is just the second derivative with respect to x. Would be the y is held constant, so that would be 2x would be the first partial with respect to x, and 2 would be the second. plus the second partial derivative with respect to y is also a 2, plus the second partial derivative of z squared with respect to z is also a 2. So this is simply a 6. Okay? So let me review. In this video, then, I introduce another differential operator, which is just the del operator dotted with itself. It's called the Laplacian. It's the sum of all the second derivatives in Cartesian coordinates, okay, in Cartesian coordinates. It can act on a scalar. It can act on a vector, and it acts on a vector by acting on these, on the components of the vector separately. You see a term like this in the Navier-Stokes equations, which is the equations governing fluid motion. It shows up in many other PDEs, including the Laplace equation, wave equation, and diffusion equation. It also shows up in the Schrodinger equation for quantum mechanics. Okay, and this is an example of how you compute the Laplacian given some scalar field. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.